Hello everyone, in this video we are going to cover this particular problem statement which is called as the last row. In this, in order to complete this obstacle, we need to verify the last row in the table displays an order value, take this value and put it in this. So if we regenerate this problem, this table might change as well. So whatever is in the last row, this particular value, that we have to pick and put it here. Okay, pause this for a moment, think about how you'll solve this and then watch the remaining video. So let's get started. So I will quickly capture the values first. So I'll fire up my scan. In case of web tables, it becomes very easy. So let me show you how it is done. So I'll click on select on screen and I'll capture this. And we have to put it here. So I'll capture this. That's all we need. I'll maximize this. And I'll just cross validate this. I'll just put a wildcard here so that just in case if the title changes a bit, we are able to handle that. Order table, we'll take a look. This looks fine. Order value, it's taking ID as order value, so we are good. I'll just rename this to the obstacle number and I'll save this. Okay. Now I'll quickly create a test case out of it. So we have captured our module. I'll put this into the test case. And I'll rename this and let's get started. So basically we have to capture the last row. Okay, so if you're scanning any web table, you will get the format displayed like row and column in your test case. Okay, now in case of TOSCA, it is very easy to select the last row. What you can do is you can click on this and here you will find this last. So you can select like this or you can put it, you can type it as well. Okay. Now we have navigated to the last row, but in our case only two columns exist. But even if more columns exist, we can find that out. Okay. So how we can do that is now we have gone to the last row. We have to get the value section. So here, whatever is there in your column section is going to appear here. So here we have type and value. So both are appearing here. We can select value in this. Okay. Now we need to capture that value. Okay. So we need to select the action mode buffer because we want to capture that value. Now, whatever value you want, you can put it here. So I can probably put it as last value or something. Okay. Now this is our buffer, which has captured the value. We have to pass this into this particular section, last order value. So all we got to do is select the action mode input and pass this buffer. Okay. So I'll put curly brackets B square brackets and I'll put the value, the buffer name, last value. I'll close this and I'll close the buffer. Okay. This should work. Let's test it out. I will run this and I'll make this in focus. So what it will do is it will first go to this table. It will navigate to the last row, capture the value and put it in the last order value. So see, our problem statement is solved. However, we did not get the pop-up which says that automation problem is solved. So we'll just see if we are doing any mistake, then take this value and put it into the text field. So sometimes what happens is if I put something, some value here. So let me copy this and put it here. So if I'm putting it here, it is giving that value, but let's see if it requires a send keys. We'll take a look into that. So I'll run into the scratchbook. It should say 7422 euros or. Okay, so see, it worked. Synchronization issue in the first time. So I hope this video series helps you. I have a lot of videos covering all the different obstacles. Do like, share and subscribe and have a great day. Thank you. Bye-bye.